Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about the various types of casting defects, their causes and the precautions taken to prevent them. So casting defects are any impressions or irregularities that result in unsuccessful casting which interfere with the fit of the final restoration or its aesthetic and mechanical properties. So casting defects can be classified as distortion, surface roughness, porosity, incomplete casting, and contamination of casting. The first one is distortion. So distortion is basically change in shape or size of casting, and both results into the misfit of casting. So distortion of the casting is usually due to distortion of wax pattern as a result of careless removal from die, too much vibration during investing, too thick investment, delay in investment which results into the release of stresses, and inhomogeneous setting and thermal expansion which causes too much longitudinal expansion. To prevent this, minimal carving should be done and there should be minimal change in temperature. The pattern should be invested within 1 hour after finishing. If storage is necessary, the pattern should be stored in refrigerator and we should leave about 3 mm gap free of ring liner at the ends, which can restrict expansion. Surface roughness is relatively finely spaced surface imperfections whose height, width and direction establish the predominant surface pattern. And if the surface roughness is present on the external surface, then it should be removed by finishing procedures. The causes of surface roughness include presence of air bubbles, which are introduced during and after investment procedure. To prevent this, vacuum investing should be done. The proper mixing of investment with use of vibrator should be done, and we should apply a wetting agent onto the surface of wax pattern. In case of water film on the surface of pattern, because wax is a water repellent, so this results into minute ridges or veins on the surface, and it this results when the pattern is moved slightly, jarred or vibrated after investment. To prevent this, we should use wetting agent and all moisture should be removed from the pattern, sprue former and ring. When there is too rapid heating, it results into the flaking of investment or fins or spines in casting, or in case salts present in the water or steam are left as deposits on the walls. To prevent this, we should gradually increase the mold temperature from room temperature to 700 degrees centigrade in 1 hour. The greater the bulk of investment, the more slowly it should be heated. Then in case of prolonged heating, there is disintegration of mold cavity, and if the sulfur compounds are present, then they can contaminate the alloy. To prevent this, mold should be heated to the casting temperature and the casting should be made immediately. So in this picture, you can see various surface irregularities on an experimental casting caused by air bubbles, water film and inclusion of foreign body. When the water powder ratio of investment is too high or low, then it results into the surface roughness. To prevent this, correct ratio should be used according to manufacturer's instructions. When there is too high casting pressure, to prevent this, we should use gauge pressure of 0.10 to 0.14 MPa in an air pressure or 3 to 4 turns of centrifugal casting machine for small castings. The composition of investment also affects the surface texture. The proportion of quartz and binder affects the surface texture, and the particle size affects the surface texture as the coarse silica results into the coarse casting. To prevent this, we should use ADS specified investments. Then presence of foreign body into the like pieces of investment or pieces of carbon from flux. To prevent this, after removing the crucible or sprue former, The ring should be tapped with a hold down. The impact of molten metal hitting the mold surface with a force may fracture or abrade the mold walls, or this can result from improper sprueing. So to prevent this, direction of sprue former should be such that molten metal does not strike a weak portion of the mold surface. Then the pattern position. If several patterns are invested in the same ring, they should not be placed too close or in the same plane. It results into the breakdown of investment. To prevent this, at least 3 mm of spacing should be present between the wedge pattern. Coming to the fins. Fins are the feather-like thin extensions in the alloy casting surfaces produced as the molten metal enters the cracks formed in the fractured investment. Causes are presence of weak investment, high water powder ratio of investment material, improper mixing and investing method, rapid temperature rise of mold, prolonged heating of investment, overheating of investment, and if the casting force is too high. So to prevent fins, proper mixing of investment should be done, precaution should be taken during heating of mold, and proper casting pressure should be used. Next type of defect is porosity. Porosity is presence of voids or pores within a structure. It can be external or internal. The disadvantages of porosity are that it weakens the casting, it results into the surface roughness, it results into discolored restoration and unhygienic restoration. So porosities can be classified into three categories. First is those caused by solidification shrinkage. It includes localized shrinkage porosity, suck-back porosity, and microporosity. Then those caused by gases, like gas inclusion porosity, pinhole porosity, and subsurface porosity. And those caused by air trapped in the mold, it includes back pressure porosity. Coming to the localized shrinkage porosity or shrink spot porosity, these are large irregular voids usually found near the sprue casting junction. It occurs when the cooling sequence is incorrect and the sprue freezes before the rest of the casting. During a correct cooling sequence, the sprue should freeze last. This allows more molten metal to flow into the mold to compensate for the shrinkage of the casting as it solidifies. If the sprue solidifies before the rest of the casting, no more molten metal can be supplied from the sprue. The subsequent shrinkage produces voids or pits known as shrink spot porosity. So to prevent shrink spot porosity, the sprue should be attached to thickest portion of wax pattern. The thickness of sprue should be more than the thickest portion of the pattern. Sprue should be flared at the point of attachment, and a large reservoir should be attached in the sprue close to its attachment to the wax pattern. Next is suckback porosity. It is a variation of the shrink spot porosity. This is an external void usually seen in the inside of a crown opposite the sprue. A hot spot is created by the hot metal impinging on the mold wall near the sprue, which causes this region to freeze last since the sprue has already solidified. So no more molten material is available, and the resulting shrinkage causes a type of shrinkage called suckback porosity. Now in this picture you can see that in a correct sequence the wax pattern should solidify first followed by the sprue, but in case of suckback porosity there is a hot spot which result into the solidification shrinkage near the hot spot. So to prevent suckback porosity, the temperature difference between the mold and molten alloy should be reduced, and point of sprue attachment should be flared. Next is microporosity. These are small regular voids within the casting. It is seen when the casting cools too rapidly and the rapid solidification occurs when the mold or casting temperature is too low. It results into the decreased strength of the casting. So it occurs due to solidification shrinkage, premature solidification, or unduly rapid solidification, and when the temperature of molten metal entering mold is low and close to its solidification temperature. To prevent this type of porosity, the temperature of casting alloy should be higher. Coming to the porosities caused by gas, these are pinhole porosity, gas inclusion porosity, and back pressure porosity. So, pinhole porosity, many metals dissolve gases when molten. Upon solidification, the dissolved gases are expelled, causing tiny voids. For example, platinum and palladium absorb hydrogen, copper and silver dissolves oxygen. So, to prevent this, the molten alloy should not be kept for a long time before the casting. Next is gas inclusion porosity. There are also spherical voids but are larger than the pinhole type. They may also be due to dissolved gases but are more likely due to gases carried in or trapped by the molten metal. So to prevent this, high speed of casting should be avoided. Next is back pressure porosity. So this is caused by inadequate venting of the mold. Air is trapped in the mold and is unable to escape. The screw pattern length should be adjusted so that there is not more than 1/4 thickness of the investment between the bottom of the casting ring and the wax pattern. When the molten metal enters the mold, the air inside is pushed out through the porous investment at the bottom. If the bulk of the investment is too great, the escape of the air becomes difficult, causing increased pressure in the mold. The metal will then solidify before the mold is completely filled, resulting in a porous casting with rounded short margins. So to avoid this, we should use investment of adequate porosity. The pattern should be placed not more than 6 mm away from the end of the ring by providing vents in large castings and by using adequate casting force. Now coming to the next type of defect, incomplete casting. So the causes are inadequate sprueing. When the sprue former is too small, so to avoid this, we should use appropriate sprue former. When the alloy is not sufficiently molten or fluid, so to avoid this, casting temperature should be at least 150 degree Fahrenheit above the fusion temperature of alloy. When the mold is too cold, so the mold should heat soak 1 hour at burnout temperature. Next cause is obstruction of the sprue by any foreign body. Then insufficient casting pressure. This results into the insufficient venting of the gases. So to avoid this, we should use centrifugal machine with good springs and several vines, or we should apply pressure at least for 4 seconds. Next reason is incomplete burnout of the wax or insufficient amount of alloy used. In this picture, you can see an incomplete casting. It usually occurs at the end of the mold. Coming to the contamination of the casting, the causes are it occurs due to oxidation when molten alloy is overheated, use of oxidizing zone of the flame, failure to use flux, and due to formation of sulfur compounds. To prevent this, the alloy should not be overheated. We should use reducing zone of the flame and flux should be used. So casting is a very important procedure for fixed partial processes or removable partial processes. It is very technique sensitive. If any step goes wrong, when casting will be defective. In almost all instances, defects in casting can be avoided by strict observance of procedures governed by certain fundamental rules and principles. Thus, with present techniques, the casting failure should be the exception, not the rule. So if you like this video, then please share it with your friends and subscribe to our channel. And in the end, thank you for watching.